A White House proposal, pushed by Ivanka Trump, would set legislative limits on a type of federal loan designed for graduate students and parents of undergraduate students. The proposal, unfiled on Monday, would require cooperation with Congress, but Democrats who controlled the House haven't said whether they would swing behind the change. The loan limit proposed by the White House would be applied to PLUS loans, which according to the student aid website are federal loans that are available to graduate or professional students and parents of dependent undergraduate students and can be used to help pay for college or career school. The principals unfiled this afternoon at a meeting of the National Council for the American Worker, set forth concrete legislative actions that, if enacted into law, would provide more Americans access to affordable and quality education, improve institutional accountability, and help students and families make informed decisions regarding their educational options, the White House press secretary said in a statement on Monday. Robert Alexander, Getty Images. An American flag flies over the South Facade of the White House in Washington, D.C. April 22, 2018. The administration's rollout comes amid broader scrutiny in higher education over inequities in the college admissions process. Last week, the Justice Department revealed that several wealthy individuals had participated in a scam to ensure their children were admitted into schools, such as Yale University and the University of Southern California. Ivanka Trump, the president's daughter who also serves as an advisor, posted on Twitter about the proposal, writing, "Today, at White House we'll be sending Congress our policy priorities to modernize our higher edu system, to ensure access to affordable, flexible, demand-driven education for Americans of all ages. We urge comprehensive higher edu reform. It is long overdue. Today, at White House we'll be sending Congress our policy priorities to modernize our higher edu system, to ensure access to affordable, flexible, demand-driven education for Americans of all ages. We urge comprehensive higher edu reform. It is long overdue." Ivanka Trump, at Ivanka Trump, March 18, 2019. Bloomberg government was first to report the administration's plans, and a White House official confirmed the reporting to ABC News. According to a memo released by the White House later, the administration wants to increase access to affordable, flexible, and innovative post-secondary education and skills attainment to meet the interests and lifelong learning needs of every American. Other priorities laid out by the Trump administration include proposals like expanding the Pell Grant to include high-quality, short-term programs that provide students with a credential, certification or license in a high-demand field, and urging Congress to reform the Federal Work-Study Program to include more opportunities for work in related fields to what the student is studying. The Trump administration also proposes simplifying the student loan system and says Congress should consolidate the 5 income-driven repayment options into one simple plan that caps monthly payment at 12.5% of a borrower's discretionary income, and should extend loan forgiveness to all undergraduate students after 180 months of repayment through an income-driven repayment plan. The White House also included a proposal for Congress to provide financial aid to prisoners eligible for release to improve employment outcomes and reduce recidivism, a proposal that comes not long after the White House and Congress worked on various prison reform initiatives. Zen. Lamar Alexander, R10, who is the chairman of the Senate Education Committee, released a statement on Monday in support of the administration's proposal. "I share the administration's goals to make a college education worth it and to make it simpler to apply for federal student aid and pay back student loans. It is helpful to have these suggestions as I work with Senator Patty Murray, the senior Democrat on the Education Committee, to develop bipartisan recommendations so that we can report legislation to the full Senate before summer. Alexander's statement said. ABC News, Jordan Phelps, Anne Flaherty and Trish Turner contributed to this report.